Right now at 6 o'clock, a severe illness affecting children and believed to be somehow linked to COVID-19. Today we learned of 4 new cases right here in North Texas. Thank you so much for joining us. It is 6 o'clock. It's good to have you. I'm Doug Dunbar. One of those children I speak of is still in the ICU this evening. Our Brooke Katz now with a look at how the kids are doing and all the symptoms that parents need to be on the lookout for.
It's a rare but serious condition hitting children, a multi-system inflammatory syndrome similar to Kawasaki disease.
The biggest concern we have right now, especially with kids, is largely stemming from inflammation around the heart.
Dr. Nicholas Richter with Cook Children's says that inflammation can cause severe problems, including heart attacks. He says all parents need to be aware. It's worth a chat with your pediatrician. Their hospital has seen 4 cases since May 9th, kids ranging in age from 6 to 14. 3 have gone home, 1 still in pediatric intensive care. All of them had exposure to COVID-19, but only 1 tested positive. Dr. Richter says that's likely because of when these symptoms come on.
What we're seeing is general inflammation following even weeks after you've had a primary COVID infection. So these are folks that may have had a very strong exposure to COVID, may have had some mild symptoms initially that may even resolve, but a few weeks later now have a big inflammatory response of their immune system.
Parents, look out for fever, abdominal pain, and evidence of inflammation like rashes, conjunctivitis, and swelling. In severe cases, the effects can be even more alarming.
You may have a lot of trouble breathing. Your blood pressures can be very low and need support. Liver and kidney damage can occur as they try to compensate for your body, and then altered mental status or even lethargy.
I know this is pretty rare at the moment. How concerned would you say parents should be, and how vigilant should they be?
I think the concern level is something for everyone to decide on their own. I think the important thing is the diligence, like, is to make this part of the conversation. You know, when your child's having unexplained fevers or inflammation, we now need to include COVID into the discussion.
Brooke Katz, CBS 11 News.